Welcome back. Today we want to add one more layer to our game. We want to ask players whether they would like to have one more card. And we try to implement this now in our game and display class. Again, we decided, which of course is a decision that you might like to change, that anything that is handling the gameplay is done in our game class, and all the interaction with players is done in the display class. This in particular is a suitable distinction if you want to change later the front end of our product. So for instance, if you want to actually do a proper GUI, then you can of course remove the display class and still the game function would work in the game class, and then you can link the different instance methods to buttons or whatever you want to do. So it gives us a bit more flexibility. Okay, the first thing we have to do is we have to now tell our game class to give one more card to a particular player. Okay, so how do we do this? Well, we go in here in our class, and let me just go to the right indentation. We use another instance method. We just call this next card, if I can spell it, and we pass in player, because we don't do it now for all the players. By default, we ask each and every player whether you actually want one more card or not. So we just pass in the player in this particular case, which we get from our interaction done in the display class. Then what we do is we remove one card from our deck and basically give it to our player. So basically we have already done that here. Let me just copy paste this and we think about this for a second. We have to go to the right level of indentation. This is just shift and the tab, and we go to that level. It's quite nice in Sublime because you have these vertical lines, so you see basically where the blocks are. I find it quite useful. Now there's one complexity here, and that is in line 44. Because we don't have the deck defined in this instance method, it's actually worked on in the previous one, the first round. So how do we get the deck.cards? There are different things we could do. We could, for instance, in the first round, return the deck.cards and then pass it into the next round. That would work. We could consider this. We could also make it global. That's another way of doing it. Or we could modify our attributes and have another attribute here, which I simply call maybe deck, where I store the deck. So it's entirely up to you. There are different ways of handling this problem. I think it's quite transparent to have it as an attribute, because then I can keep updating this. I think that is quite useful in this particular setting. I think that might be the best way of doing it, because also when I then modify the deck again for another card and another card, I can actually keep updating this. In particular, we know in the pop method, this is actually what happens. Yeah. So if we do this, we have to of course pass the information after we do our first round. So for instance, we can go in here. So this is after giving the two cards to the players. We can make here a note and just say here update deck on game instance. I should of course make it proper here, hashtag. So what we do is we just put in here self.deck and assign the updated deck.cards. Yeah, that would basically update this, and below there of course I now have to replace deck.cards with self.deck. The beauty of doing this is, so every time I run this, it immediately updates as well my attribute. Yeah, so I don't have to again pass it on or use return values and all of it. So I think this might be maybe the easiest way of doing it. Of course, there are alternatives. Okay. The next thing I want to do is I want to handle the problem which we have done actually before. What happens if I go above 21? Because we know sometimes we have a soft hand, sometimes we have a hard hand. So we have to check whether the player actually has an ace or not. Yeah. By the way, I modified here the rank assignment. So if I have an ace, I just move it as ace to 1 and I make it a bit more explicit. Don't just put in 1 as rank. I think this is more explicit. Okay, so what we do now is we just have to check. So if player.score is larger than 21, we have to check, do you have an ace? So how do we do it? Well, we use a for loop here. We loop over the cards in our player.hand. This is where we store the cards. Obviously, we pass it on to the player. And so what we do here is we check the hand, do you have an ace? So basically what we do is we say, okay, if card.rank is equal to ace. So if the card in my player hand is an ace, what do I do? In this case, because I'm above 21, I can make it soft. Yeah, I can use the soft option, so to speak, and turn this into a 1. Yeah, so what do I do? I do card.rank, I reassign this as ace 1. Yeah, it's important to change the rank because I keep checking for these aces, and if I don't overwrite the first one I find, I would find it, of course, again. And this will create, of course, errors. So we adjust our player.score directly. So I don't go through the rank and then the value property of the card class. I think this is a much more direct way of doing it. Also, we haven't implemented the ace1 rank, how this translates into the value property. So we leave it there. And we simply adjust the player score by minus 10 because I move from an 11 to a 1. Now, very crucially, we have to make sure that we only do this once. Yeah? So if you go above 21, we only adjust one ace, because potentially in round number 2, you might have 2 aces. Yeah? You might have one ace which you get in the first round, and you get now a second ace. Yeah? Only the case of 2 aces we dealt before has been resolved. So put differently, after we find the first one and we reassign it and we modify the score, I won't actually break this player score again. Yeah. Now there are different things I could do. One thing I could do is I could simply break the loop using break here, so that's a keyword. That would fix it. Another way to do it is to, instead of using here the if, use a while loop. That also works. Yeah. So again, as you see, there are many different ways you could implement the same kind of behavior. Yeah. So it's up to you. You can play around a bit and see what happens. Okay. So that should actually do it. Hopefully. I might have forgotten something. So let's move to our display. But the tricky thing is to think what happens to the deck. So what we now decide is we move our deck.cards to our new attribute deck on the game class, and then we keep modifying this every time we take a new card from the deck. We adjust the score, we check if you go above 21, and then we check do you have an ace, and we replace the first ace we get with our ace move to 1 rank, and we adjust the score. So that seems to be plausible. Good, let's go into the display class, so up here. So how do we handle it here? Now, first of all, I have to now ask in here, I changed it actually to play game. Yeah, it was before that, I think, something like, first round or so. But actually, I want to stay in the same one. I don't want to have one more instance method here. It's not helpful because then I have to again think about how I pass on the information. So I think it's better we stay in one instance method. Just call this then play game. Okay. Ask for next card. So what do we need? And we also have to make a note here. We have to adjust for bank later. So that we have to think about a bit more carefully. Okay, so what do we want? What do we need? We need to start asking every player. Yeah, and then we have to adjust that for each and every player who doesn't want to continue having more cards. So what I do is I now maybe introduce a player wants cards. I could use the number I gave before. But this is done in a separate instance method, which I did not make global. So it's easier if I use the len function on my game.players, because that's my list of players. So basically, the length of it would give me a starting value for the players I have and potentially want cards. So before I ask, I assume everyone wants a card, obviously, because then I have to start asking. Okay, so in fact, what I do is I say that the game now should stop if nobody wants more cards. So that's the idea. And what I do is I implement basically here a while loop. So while player wants cards is positive, I would simply continue asking, so to speak. So I just do that. And then I go into my player, so for player in game.players, and I now start asking. Now the thing about asking a question is they might put in invalid input. Yeah? So instead of yes, no, they might just put in something random. So it might be useful to check whether the input is valid. So we do another check here. So check whether input is valid. And I do this because there are different valid inputs using a separate variable which I call valid and another while loop where I say I run it while valid is equal to 1. So again, there are many different ways of implementing this, but because we have yes and no as an answer, sometimes it's easier to do this through a variable where I just switch the variable if I'm happy with my answer. Yeah. The first thing I think would be good to check is check whether player is bust. Yeah. So if you're anyway bust, there is no point for you taking more cards. So how do I check this? I just, of course, use an if statement. So if player.score is larger than 21, basically then I force the answer as no. Yeah. If not, I ask. So if this is not the case, I simply ask the question. So tell me, which I call answer, using the input function and using a prompt here as a formatted string. So player, I just use player name here in the placeholder. So player, whatever the name is, do you want one more card? Yes, no. Okay, so then of course, if I get now a yes, I give a card. If I get a no, I don't. If I get anything else, I would call this invalid. Yeah, so that's the idea. So I could work with that. Let me just try something like this. So I just say if the answer I get, which I should spell properly, is equal to, yes. Let's start with yes. So if you get a yes, don't forget the colon here. What happens? Well, I now use my new next card instance method, which I use on my game instance, which I already did actually in here in this method. So what I do is I simply now invoke the game next card instance method. I pass in, as we know, I have to pass in player. So I know which player basically gets what, and of course I'm in the loop here, so the player is one of the players of the game. Yeah, so that is fine. That should work. Good. So if I get a yes, I stop asking this particular round. I just say, okay, it's a valid input. Yeah, so I give that equal to zero. That would stop this one here. That would stop this round of asking. Good. Now, that should be fine. I could now also do a print statement here. So I give an output as well. Another formatted string where I again refer to player.name. So I could say something like, okay, what's the card I got? So I say received a whatever that card is. I store, of course, cards on my player.hand, which is a list. And I get the last element of that list, which is -1 using indexing, because the append method adds an item to the end of the list, which is my player.hand, which is an attribute on the player class. Okay. Put a dot here. I can maybe move to the next line to make it a bit easier to read and say your score is whatever your score is, player.score. I should not do capital here, that won't work. So I give the card, the new card you get, and I give you a score update. Okay. Good, so what else? Well, of course, the answer could be also no. So if the answer here is a no, which is, again, it's valid, so it would be valid, so put valid equal to zero, that's a valid answer. I could then adjust my player want cards. Yeah, I just put this down. So if the answer is no, well, then I basically do that. Also note, because we're on the same level of indentation, if I go above 21, the answer is no, which then moves to this if statement here, which would basically make it a valid answer and would remove this person from the player want card category. Yeah, so that would then shorten my while loop accordingly. Okay, now if I put in anything else, it would be not valid. So what I do is I just say that equal to 1. I don't actually have to do it explicitly. I can just pass that. I don't need this, but it makes it a bit more explicit. So put differently, if I add some rubbish in, I should be simply ask again. I could also, for instance, make here a statement and do another print function and put in a valid answer. Yeah, I can also do this. Fine. Good. So I'm here blackjack live. Let me just go again into my command prompt, move it a bit so that's not too small. Maybe this size is okay. Okay, go in here and run this again, python main.py. Let me see whether that actually works. I saved everything. Okay, good. Let me put in three players. I have Sue, which I'm put spell correctly. I have Amy. I have Tim. Okay, here we are. So now Sue has a three of hearts and a three of clubs, so six in total. Sue, do you want one more card? Well, yes. Okay. Sue received an eight of hearts and has now 14. One more card, Sue. Well, yes, one more card, why not? So received a 7 of hearts, and you have now 21, so black check. Do you want one more card? No, of course not. Amy, do you want one more card? Well, Amy has 18. It's a bit risky, honestly speaking. I just give it a pass. Tim, do you want one more card? Tim has 11. Well, yes. Oh, okay. So now Tim got an ace, and you see the ace is now actually moved to a 1. Yeah, so we get the right rank. And we are not moved above 21, which is correct. We just get now basically 1, so only the score is 12. So was saved by the ace, because it is a soft hand. Do you want one more card? The answer is yes, and unfortunately, you're bust, and you go above. Okay, that's pretty cool. So it's working. It's working quite fine. So that's all for today. The next thing we have to do is we have to introduce the bank. And then we kind of have to announce who actually wins. Yeah, so it's always playing against the bank, so we have to check whether your score is better than the bank score. Okay, thank you very much. I'll see you.